when you look at the numbers that he posted in the first five games, you realize that he is on course to break the all-time scoring record, average record of an NBA Finals, which is held right now by Rick Barry. But Michael alone may not be enough to win that third championship. He needs the help of his teammates. And two players in particular who struggled in Game 5, Grant and Armstrong, who combined and averaged 30 points a game between them, came up with just a total of 8 in Game 5. In Chicago is to win the third World Championship. Michael will need the help of his teammates.
So this series rolls on. A series of home court disadvantage moving back to the body of the song as the duel continues between Michael and Sir Charles.
Outdoors, 109 degrees here in Phoenix. And it's an automobile pinata. A Chicago Bulls car, we're told, 75 cents a hit, 3 for $2. So some enterprising people at work and folks here in Phoenix answering what they felt was premature celebration by the Bulls. Well, Michael Jordan getting ready for tonight's action, and we're set for the introduction of the starting lineup. Let's go to the public address voice of the Suns, Jeff Mott.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Asnerica West Arena and Game 6 of the 1993 NBA Finals between the Chicago Bulls and your Phoenix Suns. Now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineup for the Chicago Bulls. At forward, from Clemson, number 54, Horace Grant. At forward, from Central Arkansas, number 33, Scotty Pippen. At center, from San Francisco, number 24, Bill Cartwright. At guard, from Iowa, number 10, B.J. Armstrong. And at guard from North Carolina, number 23, Michael Jordan. Chicago Bulls head coach, Phil Jackson.
Because they weren't able to close this thing out on Friday. That's not the case. They all were very upbeat and all very confident. Now, Now, you and Mike talked about the supporting cast role of Michael Jordan. One, Horace Grant. I asked Michael about that. He said the one guy that you don't have to worry about on this team tonight is Horace Grant. He has come to play. Hannah?
Ahmad, the Suns may be facing elimination for the sixth time in these playoffs, but they are as loose as ever. Danny Ainge missed a shoot around before the game, but everyone was teasing him about it. No one was mad, not even Coach Paul Westfall. Also, Westfall was kidding Barkley about the fact that he had half as many rebounds as Dan Marley in Game 5. So Barkley came back and promised Westfall flat out that he would have no less than 17 boards tonight. By the way, Barkley's injured elbow is feeling much better. Here's the indicator. Barkley played golf on it for the first time yesterday. Mark?
All right, Hannah. 17 rebounds promised by Charles. The officials, Darryl Garrison, Mike Mathis, Ed T. Rush, Bill Cartwright will jump against Mark West, and the Suns control the opening tip. Kevin Johnson guarded by B.J. Armstrong. Dan Marley played by Michael Jordan. And here is Richard Dumas. Richard Dumas had the terrific inning in Chicago on Friday night. And Horace Grant going to the hoop. And he hurt himself. Mark West, who was not in early foul trouble on Friday night, which was a major factor, picked up that foul. Horace Grant said after the game the other night it was the worst performance of his life. 38 minutes, 0 for 4, only 1 point, and the Bulls trying to get him involved right at the start.
You saw two things happen early for Chicago. One, Michael Jordan going to the defensive boards to help his team out. They were out-rebounded by 10 last game. Second was Horace Grant early trying to get himself out in the open floor, pick up an easy scoring opportunity. Two things that were a concern after Game 5.
Horace only 1 of 4 from the line on Friday night. And it was one of the situations where, with Horace, who has had a terrific playoff run, it was not the foul trouble that cost him the other night. Pippen able to keep it alive. Tries to feed Grant, broken up by Marley.
And perhaps on Scottie Pippen's mind, keep going to Horace early in the game. Let's try and get him going. And he's good. He's very good.
Nice lead. Dumas was rejected by Grant. Good luck from Kevin Johnson, but Dumas was stopped. Michael Jordan on a pull-up. Yes. The Bulls 3, and the Suns nothing.
Just at the moment that Jordan was ready to pull up, Richard Dumas, who had picked him up in transition, lost his footing, slipped, and gave Michael a wide-open look at the rim.
Now Barkley backs on Grant. No help at the start of the move, and Cartwright came over, and a foul is called. So Barkley will go to the line. Cartwright picked up the foul.
The value of Grant to the Chicago defense, his ability to rotate over and block or change shots. And then an early commitment by Chicago. Here comes Cartwright late. They want to double team big against Charles Barkley.
Charles Barkley, a 76% free throw shooter this past season. That was his best mark in his NBA career. Now the crowd trying to get the Suns into it early. In this series, Charles 35 of 46 for the night for 76%, but he misses on his first two. Marley. Dan Marley getting inside. The Bulls 3, the Suns 2. Played by Dumas. Johnson battling for position was called for that foul.
Hey, one way to get Kevin Johnson off of Michael Jordan is get fouls on him early. They feel that Johnson has the ability out in front to move his feet and stop Michael's penetration. Michael goes right down low, doesn't mess around with the perimeter game, posts him up.
Jordan and Barkley on the run. Ball's able to get back. Right over to help out. And again, the Suns play it beautifully. It goes through Barkley, and it led to the quick passing and the field goal by West.
Exactly what we had mentioned that Phoenix did in Chicago Stadium, matured as an offensive team in the half court, willingness to swing the basketball to the opposite side of the floor.
Shot clock at 5. Armstrong for 3. Armstrong, who had Chicago. Able to connect from downtown. The ball six and the Suns four. Marley got the step. Yes, and it counts.
Defense apart.
We were talking with Dan Marley prior to the game about the fact that he has been more effective going to the basket. We saw that on Friday night. He now is taking advantage of the Bulls not allowing him the deep shot, and he's been getting the step as he did right there. The foul is called on Jordan, who's first. It'll be Chicago ball, 13 on the 24.
You see the unusual matchups of Kevin Johnson on Michael Jordan, Marley guarding Pippen, and Dumas guarding BJ. The thought there, two superstars, Pippen and Jordan. Let's take one of them out of it, put Marley on. Pippen reduces game.
And Scottie Pippen will go to the line as Mark West is called for his second foul. So a quick two on West.
If Phoenix is to win, Mark West and Oliver Miller will have to play significant minutes in tonight's game. And the guy who must understand this is Tom Chambers. When one of those two big bodies are out there, they block up, they clog the lane, they reject shots, they put a big body against the Chicago team. Chambers is a different kind of player, not trying to take anything away.
Well, you can see the way the Bulls have been struggling at the foul line. Pippen hits one out of two from the line. Bulls 16 for 24 from the line on Friday and killed them 67%, while the Suns were at 81% from the line. The game is tied at 7. Dumas working off the dribble. Now Marley, again not given the room. Shot clock at 6. Barkley stolen by Jordan. Here's Jordan on the run. Jordan loses Barkley, able to steal. Charles did it with a smile. Slices through to set up Marley for three. The hustle by Barkley. And a timeout was called. Smart play by Charles. He indicated the timeout to Darryl Garrison. So he was able to save it. It's a 20-second timeout.
When Charles Barkley faces up and starts to put it on the floor, Michael Jordan was the next closest man. Michael's decision, do I leave Marley, the three-point shooter, and help out? He caught Charles right in the middle of the dribble. But Charles never gave up. Jordan loses the handle. Charles runs him down from behind. He even gets a little chuckle out of it. Get possession, call timeout before you go out of bounds. Excellent move by Charles Barkley. There's a gentleman on the floor, Eddie Rush, one of the officials who, this is his 26th game in the NBA Finals. When you get to number 25, you receive a world championship ring. This man is to be commended for the number of years that he's put both in the ABA and NBA. Finals game number 26 for Ed Rush. Congratulations.
Yes, an impressive run for Ed T. Rush. Dumas with a save. And a foul call. A pushing foul brought to Scottie Pippen. That is a third team foul called on Chicago.
From the timeout, the backdoor lob, which is something Phoenix likes to do. The shove, the body up by Pippen.
Barkley backing Grant Armstrong, cheating over. And they work it from the line. Yes.
Defense to get there in time, particularly with Marley's range and his ability to stretch the defense out.
Suns lead by three. They double on Jordan. Shot clock at 6. Conright. Very quiet in game number 5. He has made his contributions, but they came earlier in the series, and they came against the Knicks in the Eastern Conference Final. He has been silent as of late. Suns lead 10-9. Kevin Johnson. And it's tipped over. Richard Dumas with the tip. Suns 12, Bulls 9. Jordan for 3. And Michael Jordan has tied the game at 12.
Phoenix Phoenix has to be concerned that Richard Dumas doesn't get his head down and disturbed because he's guarding Michael Jordan. That's happened to a lot of players. They play so hard on defense, and it doesn't seem to affect Jordan. They forget their offensive game.
Adam Johnson providing a two-point lead for the Phoenix Suns. Open shot for Pippen. Barkley for Johnson goes all the way. Phoenix 16, Chicago 12.
I don't think Phil Jackson's fine right now. He knew that Phoenix was going to come out and play with such an emotional hot. It's a matter of withstanding it during the first quarter. Be close enough to then make a run.
Scottie Pippen with his first field goal. Molly breaking down. Molly had the rebound knocked away by Grant. And he was looking for a foul. And a hesitation dribble. Crowd roaring. They thought he stepped out of bounds. Jordan hits another three. So the Bulls lead by one. Michael Jordan has hit two from three-point land. 6:20 remaining in this first quarter. Game six of the best of seven. If the Suns win it, there will be a game seven here in Phoenix on Wednesday. Foul call on Armstrong.
Michael Jordan showing both parts of his game early, down low, inside, posting up against Kevin Johnson, and now he's catching Richard Dumas, the rookie, in late rotations, stops behind the three-point line, hits one, KJ moves back to guard him, he just shoots right over the top again from behind the three-point line.
Timeout taken, 6:13 left in the first. While some Phoenix players felt that Michael Jordan was fatigued at the end of Game 5 on Friday night, Charles Barkley, though, has a different point of view on that matter. We discussed that with Charles earlier.
Well, I thought Michael was tired the last game. But, you know, the thing that amazes me the most, people want to say, why can't the Bulls hold these leads and what's wrong with the Bulls? Not what's wrong with the Bulls. It's that we got the best team in the NBA. We proved that throughout the regular season. And we're going to keep on proving it. There's nothing wrong with the Bulls. We just had the best record in the NBA, and we've proven that all year. We are the best team in the world.
Charles Barkley supporting the Muhammad Ali theory of ultimate confidence throughout this entire series. Honestly believes in his team that they're going to get it done.
Armstrong with the open shot, and the Bulls now lead it 19-16.
These two teams have done it differently. All seven of Chicago's field goals have come from the outside. Perimeter shot as Pippen comes up with the steal. For Phoenix, five of their seven field goals have been layups or dunks.
A hard foul given by Oliver Miller. And Scottie Pippen is shaken up.
There's no question that Phoenix liked what they saw in the last game about their physical defense. There's no way that they're going to allow Chicago to get to the rim for easy dunks and scores.
Oliver Miller checking in a moment ago, replacing Mark West, and here's Scottie Pippen to the foul line. The Bulls having their problems once again at the line.
You have to look at it this way. Between your two centers, and I'm talking about Mark West, Oliver Miller, you have 12 personal fouls to give up. Then you have Tom Chambers, a different type of center who can come in, use up six more. 18 personal fouls, don't let him get easy scores.
Bulls shooting very well, though, from the field here in the first quarter. They've hit on 7 out of 9, and they lead it 20-16. Dumas, Barkley, Miller up front, Marley, and Johnson at the guards. Now single coverage on Barkley. Here's Dumas. Well, Dumas has been off.
And the change up by Chicago. No Bill Cartwright double teaming. That time Michael Jordan came on the double team.
Jordan coming late after Barkley was able to back into position. Here's Pippen. Gives it back to Jordan, looking for his third three-pointer. The save by Grant. And the Bulls will regroup just under 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Jordan picks it back out. Cartwright able to get back to it, goes down. Johnson with the steal. Three on one. Martin from Barkley. Johnson.
possession of the ball, which turns immediately into a transition opportunity for Phoenix. Pippen tries to take a charge, but he's under the rim. The official's not going to give it to you there, so the block is called.
Second on Pippen. Danny Ainge has come on for the first time. Ainge replacing Dumas. Richard Dumas, a field goal, 2 points. 4:35 remaining. First quarter. The Bulls 20. The Suns 19.
I'm a little uncertain coming down exactly what they were trying to get into after that free throw.
5 of the 24. Grant. Jordan. Pitches back to Grant. Pippen with the snap. Oh, what a move by Scottie Pippen. And the Bulls now lead by 3. Ainge on a quick release for 3. Ainge has tied the game at 22. Armstrong for 3. E.J. Armstrong hitting on his second three-pointer from the very same spot.
With
a three-point lead. Pippen with the spin. Bulls have hit 4 out of 5 from downtown. Jordan went for the crossover. And Barkley leads a 4-on-3. Fouled by Jordan. It's a blocking foul. That is his second.
Back a moment ago to Chicago on offense. Pippen. A great pass by Charles Barkley. He's got to try and dunk and finish the play. Jordan trying to step in to steal it. A little bit too much body in there.
And Barkley will go to the line. The Bulls are over the limit. Michael Jordan was able to strip Barkley earlier and was looking to do the same. That led to the foul call at center court. Now Phil Jackson takes a timeout. 3:09 remaining in this first quarter.
On offense, Scottie Pippen realizes that Miller can't move his feet. It's a matter, can he elevate over Charles? He certainly can.
Well, right throughout the playoffs, the Bulls have had major problems at the foul line. Michael Jordan included. He was only 7 of 10 on Friday night. At the Bulls' shoot-around this morning, all Michael did was practice foul shooting. Friday night, Bulls 16 of 24 from the line, and off to the slow start today at 3 of 6. We talked about that with Coach Phil Jackson.
There's some people on this team that aren't going to shoot better than 70%. If they get foul shots, we got to make the most out of it. Rebound offensively off the free throw line, do the best job you can. The guys that are shooters that can shoot that 75 plus, concentrate, go up there, use all the fundamentals that you have. The rest of it's all poise and confidence that helps you go. And that's where we have to be a little more confident. I thought we got a little bit tight the other night in the fourth quarter. We were pushing from behind for too long and probably short-armed a few of our free throws.
During the regular season, Chicago shot at a 73% rate. For the playoffs, all 18 games, they're shooting 73%. But in this series against Phoenix, they're shooting just 64% from the foul line.
And that is very poor. Bulls now lead by 1. John Paxson and Scott Williams have come on for the first time. Just under 3 minutes left in this first quarter. Williams to the drive. Nice move by Scott Williams. And the Bulls have a three-point advantage. Here's some light pressure, but Kevin Johnson brings it across.
It's a big start and a good start for Scott Williams. He's a guy who in the finals has provided them a spark. He hasn't done that in the last couple games, but already a score and a big rebound.
Paxson. He was looking for the three. Armstrong. Played now by Miller on a switch. Armstrong shooting over him. And a foul is called. Foul on the Bulls. A loose ball call. Looks to be on Grant.
The big first step. And and then the finish of the hook on the run by Scott Williams gives the young man a little energy, gets him back into the game. He has not contributed the way he wants to, the way the Bulls team needs him the last couple games. That's a good quick start for him.
And that last foul was called on Horace Grant. Chicago over the limit, so it puts Marley at the line.
And talking about Marley, there's another man who in Game 5 came up with 11 points already here in Game 6, 12 points for Dan Marley.
Including one from three-point range. In Game 3 of the triple overtime, these two clubs combined for an NBA Finals record 14 three-pointers. They already have combined for six in this first quarter. We come up on 2 minutes remaining in the quarter. Jordan. Yes, and Michael Jordan has 10 points, the Bulls 29, and the Suns 26, both clubs shooting well.
Michael Jordan saw the double team coming from the top, the foul line area. What he did is he turned immediately to the baseline, away from the double team, so it wouldn't affect his shot. He knows he can jump over the top of Kevin Johnson and get a good look.
Barkley. Charles continues to struggle from the outside. That's where the Bulls like to see him shooting from. A good position by Williams, but he was rejected. Miller with the block. Barkley from the contact. Phoenix felt there should have been a foul in the backcourt as Kevin Johnson went down. They get the call up front. Armstrong fouling Barkley.
When Michael Jordan gets into this area and posts up, the double team is going to come from here. What he does immediately is turn away from it towards the baseline to get the shot off. If he turned to the middle of the lane, he would turn right into the double team. Instead, turning away, he gets a good look.
Michael Jordan with 10 points, leading the Bulls. Dan Marley leading Phoenix with 13. Barkley only 2 out of 4 from the line. And now B.J. Armstrong will sit down. Trent Tucker comes on for the first time. B.J. 3 out of 4, including 2 3-pointers for 8 in all. Notice Charles Barkley does not have the pad on the sore right elbow, so obviously it is feeling much better. The Suns, 28 with a minute and a half to go in this first quarter. Bob Albert along with Nazar Patello, Shredder, Mike Patello, Mike Richard, and a score. Tucker to three. Trent Tucker buries the three-pointer.
So sit the league's best three-point shooter down and B.J. Armstrong. Bring a guy in like Trent Tucker who does the same job. Puts three-pointers right in the bottom of the net.
Chicago, 5 out of 6 from three-point territory.
Because Oliver Miller stepped up big and wasn't going to let him to the front of the rim.
Give and go did not work between Jordan and Grant, but deflected out by Phoenix.
And you have to like the style of basketball. Pass, cut, get it back, look to try to play unselfishly.
Bulls with 8 on the 24. 45 seconds left in this first quarter.
That'll guarantee over perhaps talking about a fan, a heckler who may be bought. And there is the guy that he was talking about right behind the Chicago bench who was thrown out of a previous game here in this building by NBA security.
Mike Jordan from long range. That's a three. Michael Jordan with his third three-pointer and the Bulls now lead by 7. Inside off the double team and went to the fadeaway. Rebounded by Grant.
The big double team. Grant and then Williams coming over. Just like early in the game when Cartwright came to double team. Chicago changing up the people that come. That big one effective against Charles Barkley.
Final seconds on the corner. Here's Paxson. Counts. John Paxson with a buzzer basket concluding this first quarter. And And the Chicago Bulls with a good run to end the quarter.
28.
They lead the Phoenix Suns 37-28.
You work on dribble penetration, meaning try to draw two defensive players off the dribble. There's one double team off the dribble. It draws Dumas. He should never have left Paxson alone for an open shot to end it. John Paxson's not going to miss many of those.
A hot shooting. First quarter for the Bulls, 14 of 22 for 64%, and they finish it up with a 10-2 run. Well, you are looking at the NBA's most notorious fan, professional heckler. Would you believe this man is an attorney? His name is Robin Ficker. I know many of you are aware that he usually sits behind the visiting bench in Landover for Washington Bullets games. Well, he's here in Phoenix, and Horace Palmer, the director of security for the NBA, ushered him aside. They are apparently not throwing him out. I know Robin from time to time has made mention of his constitutional rights. Hey, you should be able to, according to Robin, say obnoxious things to an NBA coach. I know you go along with that philosophy as well.
Fans are entitled to come in, cheer, root against the opposition. But when it gets personal and this man goes over the line, he makes it personal, he makes derogatory remarks to players and to coaches. I don't think there's a place for that. No one wants to see a player or a coach react and go into the stands. Well, then you must protect those people with security enforcement. Get those type of people out of the stands.
Foul on Scott Williams. He was here the other day, and Phil Jackson of the Bulls were saying, hey, they wouldn't be surprised if the Phoenix Suns actually gave a free seat and put him right behind the bench. Charles Barkley claimed that he bought the seat for him. And he was being facetious. Here's Danny Ainge. Rebounded by Scott Williams. Let's go over to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, Marv, I just spoke with Daryl Gerritsen, and he told me that he had given this fellow one warning, and if he had to warn him again, he was out of here. Mark?
Scott Williams gets inside. Minute gone by in the second quarter, and the Bulls 37, the Suns 28. Here's Kevin Johnson. 7-point Chicago lead. Following the two poor games here in Phoenix, Kevin Johnson redeemed himself in Chicago. He's averaged 23 points a game in Chicago. It's Tucker again. Kevin Johnson averaging 23 per game over the three contests in Chicago after scoring a total of only 15 of the two games here in Phoenix. John Paxson called for the hold. Here's Scottie Pippen making his return. And Marley will check back in, as will B.J. Armstrong. And Michael Jordan gets a rest. 5 of 8 from the field for Jordan. 3 from downtown. 13 points in all. Johnson using the screen. Trying to do it off the dribble. Could not finish. Armstrong.
Oh!
Rebounded by Pippen. Crowd wants a travel. No call made. Foul committed by Dumas, trying to slap the ball away.
You can see a sharpness, a crispness to Chicago's half-court offense.
Timeout taken. 9:53 remaining. First half. Early last week, Phil Jackson made it clear that he was hoping the Bulls would wrap it up in Chicago because, you see, he had these tickets for a Grateful Dead concert, which was taking place over the weekend at Soldier Field in Chicago. And here's the reaction by Danny Ainge after the Suns were able to bring the series back to Phoenix. Said, well, we were motivated to keep Phil Jackson from that Grateful Dead concert, but that was for his benefit. I asked Phil about it before the game. He said, well, his wife and the kids did enjoy the concert back in Chicago. Bulls lead by 9. 9:40 remaining in the second quarter. Scottie Pippen. Rebounded by Scott Williams. Yes! pass and it counts.
There's the active Scott Williams that the Chicago Bulls team needs coming off the bench, asserting himself on the glass. You would say playing big around the boards, goes after it. He has great hands, the strength, forces his way back up to score the basket, and now the free throw opportunity.
Too strong, but Pippen is there. That was blocked by West. 3-on-2. Marley for three. And again, it's Williams on the rebound. Scott Williams has been an enormous factor off the bench. Bulls lead by 11. Shot clock at three. Took an extra step. Traveling violation.
I don't think Phil Jackson quite agrees that he took any extra step. It was just a finish of a, if you call it 1-2, 1-2 and the hook. Pretty good argument.
The Bulls in the midst of a 14-4 spurt. Barkley. And it will be Phoenix ball. Charles Barkley is 0 for 4 from the field.
4 points for Barkley, 1 point for Grant.
All of Barkley's scoring coming from the foul line. Now Stacey King will come on, replacing Horace Grant.
When you have a player like Horace Grant who matches up against Charles Barkley, you understand that at the end of the night, if you're looking at points, there's going to be a differential probably in favor of Charles Barkley. But what you want is, you want the differential to not be real big, like a, you know, 28-1 differential.
Marley, 15 for Marley. Chicago leading 41-32. Pressing Armstrong. King, Williams, Pippen up front. Here's Tucker. Oh, Trent is on fire. When he takes that shot and hits it, moving to the left off the dribble, you know that he feels the touch. What a move by Kevin Johnson. The Bulls now lead 43-34.
Phoenix not giving Chicago's defense a chance to set up, get it in after score, get it right back at it.
Scottie Pippen trying to go glass. Danny Ainge with the rebound. Ainge for three. Yes. That is his second three-pointer. The Bulls 43, the Suns 36. Holding foul called on Johnson.
Transition basketball. Chicago scored, Phoenix comes right back at you, KJ pushing it, again, in transition, the way they love to play, secure it, get down the floor, and then Danny Ainge is not going to hesitate if you give him a look to get it up there from downtown.
Tom Chambers coming on for the first time, played only 1 minute on Friday night following the 1-for-9 from the field in the previous game. King starting his move against Oliver Miller. Rejected by Miller.
You mentioned Tom Chambers on the floor, but he's on the floor as a power forward because that man, Oliver Miller, is playing the center position. So one of the two, West Miller on the floor.
12 on the 24. 7.5 remaining in the first half. King had it knocked away.
But one thing he can do, Oliver Miller, is block and chain shots with that long arm span. Here, he should be going up strong to dunk. It's Michael Jordan that he's going against. By trying to lay it off the glass, he misses the first opportunity.
And they say a non-shooting foul. The steal by Pippen. Ainge diving for it. Able to get a foul.
few moments ago, Danny Ainge came down in transition, pulled up behind the three-point line, and clearly hit a three-point shot. From what we understand, the officials have changed it and awarded him only 2 points. Scramble, madness, loose ball, bodies on the floor.
And Danny Ainge of the Phoenix Suns, only the fifth player ever to play for three different teams in the NBA Finals. Ainge joining the likes of Wilt Chamberlain, Clyde LaBella, Larry Faust, Max Krzyzewski, Danny Ainge, a member of two Boston Celtic championship squads. Bulls lead it by five. And Miller was pushed. Johnson in the backcourt. Oliver Miller will shoot a pair. Oliver Miller making his first appearance at the line. He's a 71% free throw shooter. Oliver Miller, a player who has slimmed down to about 285 pounds. He had a weight problem right throughout his college career. I know Charles Barkley has been very helpful in giving advice to Oliver, who's worked hard at it and has been able to cut into that weight when you look back at what he looked like during the course of training camp.
And to Charles Barkley, also a player who, when he came out of Auburn, was up close to 280 pounds, now plays in that 254, 255 area. He made a commitment to be a good player. I think Oliver Miller realized that he's got a chance to be an outstanding player, but he's got to keep the weight down.
8-0 run by the Suns. Bulls at 1 point, led by as many as 11. It is now a three-point lead. Marley played by Grant. Marley to the fadeaway. Grant with the save.
It shows you the ability of Horace Grant to move those feet. He was isolated against Dan Marley. Did a good job and forced Marley into a bad shot.
Hot right for Pippen. Yes. Scottie Pippen, who did not have an impact game in Chicago on Friday. Rare off performance. Scottie 8 for 20, 22 points. But thus far tonight, 8 points, couple of steals. Played well. Down. Armstrong and Jordan at the guards. Cartwright, Pippen, Grant up front.
Ainge trying to keep the ball out of Michael Jordan's hands. So what does Michael do? He can't get it on the outside. He goes down and posts up.
Shot clock at three. Pippen. Chambers with the rebound. Kevin Johnson. Ball on Chambers.
If Michael can't touch it, then he can't shoot it. Danny Ainge trying to deny it without the basketball, so Michael goes down into the box area, waits for the team to reverse the ball, get it to him in that scoring position.
Here's Charles Barkley returning, replacing Oliver Miller. The Bulls are 4 for 14 from the field. In the second quarter, they were 14 for 22. They were hot in the first. Barkley now guarding Cartwright. And Cartwright looks to post him up. The ball awarded to the Suns.
I see two teams out here, Marv, that because of the emotion of the game, the heat in the building, and the pace of this game, are dragging a little bit right now. They're searching for that second win.
And outdoors, 109 degrees in the Valley of the Sun. 4:20 remaining, first half. Chambers with the shot. Oh, it goes to the reverse. Chicago's lead is 3. Bulls have missed 5 of their last 6. Jordan met by Chambers and fouled.
And the Suns are now over the limit.
So back to the offensive end. The good screen was set by Chambers. KJ got on the ball, and then leaving no doubt, he took a lesson from Oliver Miller about missing those easy ones off the glass. Chambers throws it down with a little reverse.
Tom Chambers tomorrow will celebrate his 34th birthday. Players have back problems, hamstring problems. Discussion between Jordan, Pippen, and the three officials. Michael Jordan, I would think, is claiming. Although, wait a moment. The Suns are over the foul limit, so he goes to the line no matter what. So he cannot be talking about whether he was fouled in the end.
What mic is on? I'm going to guess that. After the, he's taking full responsibility.
I'll keep quiet for a second.
Change that they made to two. I think the referees conferred and are trying to get it right.
But how would they just suddenly realize that now? You can't go to replay unless someone told them that they saw the replay, someone from the league. If that's the way it was done, it's wrong.
Well, sometimes officials don't get a chance to confer until the next dead ball. They all get together, they put their thoughts together, and go from there.
That was several minutes ago, though. But they made the change, even though it's the right call. If they got help, and I'm just guessing, maybe that might not be the issue here. That would be wrong. So the Bulls with a two-point lead. We're down to 4 minutes. Bang, first half. Barkley backing. Barkley gets inside. And that is his first field goal. Charles, his first.
Charles realizes that the double team is coming from the middle, so if he can turn to the baseline and get it up before they can get there, Scott Williams tried to come middle and readjust coming baseline when he saw Barkley turning away, but it was too late.
Charles Barkley, 1-for-5 from the field, only 6 points. He's got it at the free throw line. And a timeout taken. Remaining. First half, it's Chicago by one.
Okay, coming up on the Prudential Halftime Report, we'll be joined live by NBA Commissioner David Stern. Plus, we'll get Quinn Buckner's thoughts on the first half between the Bulls and the Suns. That's at halftime. Now we send it back to the floor. And here again are Marvin Mike.
All right, Bob. Good run here by the Suns, trailing by as many as 11. And they are now within 1 point.
Let's go back to that controversial call. Danny Ainge pulling up from behind the three-point line. Daryl Garrison came over to us just a few seconds ago, explained what had happened was Mike Mathis went over and said that he had given a wrong signal indication. They waited till the game stopped. They got together, they clarified it, and on the next dead ball is when they are technically able to go and make the correction. That's what they did.
Chicago is 4-for-10 from the line. The Bulls 47, the Suns 45, and light pressure being exhibited by Chicago. Marley protects the dribble, moving it across against Pippen. Barkley, played by Grant. It's a one-on-one, no help. Now here comes Williams, Barkley with the fadeaway. Off. 1-for-6 from the field for Charles Barkley.
Nice shot by Grant.
Williams. Shot a back top. Johnson with the cutoff.
Chicago got caught, the five offensive players of Phoenix against four for Chicago, because after Scott Williams made the strong move to the basket and no foul was called, he laid on the floor. Everybody else runs down. He thinks he draws enough contact. He tips it out but falls, and now he lays there. He can't believe it. Instead of getting up and hustling back, the frustration, five against four, Chambers gets fouled.
Tom Chambers, an excellent foul shooter, 84% for the season. He can tie the game here. To the reverse. Barkley called for his second foul.
A little bit of change this time. Instead of turning baseline and shooting a jumper, he keeps the dribble alive, and now with the ability to stay in the air, draw body contact, and still try and get a shot up there, Michael Jordan will go to the free throw line for two.
Bulls have gone cold in the second quarter after the sharply played first quarter. Suns with a 15-4 run. And now the Bulls lead by one. Frank Johnson checking in, replacing Tom Chambers. Chambers hears it. 6 points. Good job off the bench for the veteran Tom Chambers. The Bulls lead 49-47. Johnson on the floor at the same time, but it's Danny Ainge handling the ball. Jordan over to help on Barkley. Good job by Pippen on Marley. Now two. Frank Johnson got inside.
Excellent defense that time. Chicago double team. Phoenix cut it out. Chicago made the rotation. Pippen down in transition. Bothered by Dan Marley.
And a foul is called. Stop the fast break. And that is number three for Horace Grant. And Horace once again has been quiet in this first half. 0 for 3 from the field. 1 out of 2 from the line. Only 1 point.
What happened was Chicago came out shooting the ball so well from the perimeter that they really didn't have an opportunity to get Horace involved down low. They made a lot of perimeter shots that were going in. Remember we said last game, when you live by the sword, you die by the sword. If that fatigue eventually catches up with you, and you continue to shoot jump shots, you won't make them as well in the fourth quarter, it could be a problem.
And Scott Williams will replace Horace Grant, who has accounted for only 2 points the last 6 quarters.
So when you're struggling with offense, you do other things. You rebound, you play defense. You block shots, you change shots, you run the floor, you set screens. Horace Grant knows that. He'll work his way out of it.
Barkley 5-for-7 from the line. Suns and the Bulls tied at 49. Just under 2 minutes remaining. First half. This game fix of the best of 7. Pippen with a beautiful move, and he's given Chicago a 2-point lead. Bulls hoping to wrap it to make it 3 in a row, preventing a game 7 here on Wednesday. And the Suns looking to tie the series at 3. Barkley draws the double team. Here's Ainge, way off of that 3-point attempt.
Last time down, a little cat and mouse game between Marley and Pippen. Marley kept backing up, hoping that Pippen would shoot the jumper. Instead, Pippen took it right to him, just like B.J. Armstrong did in transition for Chicago.
And that is 3 on Barkley.
Chicago secures the ball and outlets it. B.J. takes it the rest of the way. Barkley goes up, tries to avoid the contact. B.J. helps a little bit by jumping into him. And Charles a little bit frustrated at the offensive end because he can't find
Fox, who can get a good look to throw out of that double team. He's either got to get rid of it a little bit sooner, or they've got to do something else in their offense. A little wrinkle, change their cuts to the basket to help Charles see him more easily.
Mark West checking back in. Bulls now lead by three. Phoenix assistant coach Scotty Robertson made the point the other day. He thought it was a blessing in disguise when Charles Barkley suffered that injured right elbow in game two, because, of course, everyone around Barkley going to get more involved. But I don't think they were too pleased about Charles picking up a third foul. They are keeping him on the floor. But there is truth in that, with Charles not able to go at his usual pace. Other players were able to step up. And a loose ball foul is called. And Don West. And that is four on West.
I think that Charles Barkley went out to him when he first came out. The screen is trying to be set that time, and as the ball gets tipped away, West reaches out and pushes Scottie Pippen. But Barkley had gone up to West when he came on the floor and basically said, look, we need you out there to play big. That's the gamble that you take as a coach, putting a guy on the floor with three. He may pick up his fourth before halftime. Charles Barkley, another player with three, out on the floor for Phoenix. But then again, there is no tomorrow if Phoenix doesn't win this basketball game.
Scottie Pippen is now 2-for-5 from the line. Well, the conversation continues between Charles Barkley and Michael Jordan. Chicago 54 and Phoenix 49.
I'm a little nervous for Phoenix with a minute to go. Time to get Barkley out of there. He has three. You can hold on for the last minute.
And Johnson lost her. In particular with Mark West coming back, and you know Paul Westphal will be second guessed on that. West picks up a fourth foul. Armstrong, that was deflected. Barkley got a piece of it. Saw it all the way.
Just like I said, leave Charles Barkley on the floor.
That was only his second field goal. Chicago leads by three. Half minute left, first half. Here's Pippen.
Not even a challenge that time. Smart by Charles Barkley. Let him go. He got you deep enough. If he makes it, he makes it. Don't challenge him. Pick up the next foul.
13 points for Pippen. Phoenix will hold for a last shot. 15 seconds left in the quarter. They are down by five. Five seconds remaining. Barkley off the dribble. Here's Barkley. Halftime here at the America West Arena in Phoenix. The Chicago Bulls leading the Phoenix Suns 56-51. Bob Costas coming up with the Prudential halftime report. We'll be back in a moment. Into the second half. Well, throughout the series, the Bulls' offense has been dominated by the scoring of that man, Michael Jordan. As you can see, 50% of the offense game four, 42% in game five with a 41-point total. But today, it has been a different story. Percentage of Bulls points thus far, Jordan 29% with his 16 points. The supporting cast has stepped up. At least they did in the first half.
Actually, the last field goal attempt that Michael Jordan got credit for, because you don't get a field goal attempt if you're fouled and the shot does not go in, was with 40 seconds left in the first quarter. He picked up 3 points in the second quarter from the foul line.
And Jordan gets right back to it. The Bulls lead by 7. 18 points for Michael Jordan to lead Chicago. 13 for Scottie Pippen. B.J. Armstrong has 10. Phoenix. Charles Barkley with 10, only 2 of 7 from the field. Here's Dumas, and he is fouled.
That's excellent pass that time by Tom Chambers. He started to take the ball to the basket. He saw Chicago step up and rotate. He made the next pass on the swing.
Horace Grant called for number four. Four fouls on Grant, who has been quiet for the second straight game.
Pippen steps up as Grant comes over. He tries to avoid the contact, but it's too late.
Paul Westphal starting Tom Chambers instead of Mark West. West picking up his fourth foul in the latter stage of the second quarter. So it is Chambers, Dumas, and Barkley on the front line with Johnson and Marley up in the back door. Now Scott Williams replaces Horace Grant. The Bulls very fortunate with Grant again being ineffective that Scott Williams has had a good one.
Horace Grant, you saw looking over at the coaching staff, kind of with this puzzled look on his face, as if to say, what are you doing taking me out this early? John Bach, the assistant, leaned over, held up four fingers and said, Horace, you've got four fouls on you. He needs you at the end of the game.
Jordan, rebound, Barkley. Phoenix trailing by five. Barkley.
Tries to get over in front of him. The feeling is that Barkley initiated the contact by dipping the left shoulder. Charles can't believe it.
And wanted to travel on Cartwright. Scottie Pippen drives it home. And the Bulls now lead by seven.
It's a tough decision now for Paul Westphal. Do you leave Charles Barkley in? Remember, he just told Lannis Thorpe that Charles is going to have a big offensive half, which meant they wanted to go to him. Now, picking up his fourth, he's going to leave him on the floor for the moment, but I don't know how long he can go with Charles.
Scott Williams called for the foul. And Tom Chambers will have to come on. So that's three on Williams. Chambers two for two from the line.
As a coach, what you're saying is, if I knew we could hang around without Charles on the floor, we buy some time. We take him out. You bring someone in off the bench, Oliver Miller, whoever it might be, to do the job, and then bring Charles back later on in the quarter or for the entire fourth quarter. But there's no guarantee. A team like Chicago could open it up quickly. You never catch back up again against their defense. So the feeling by Paul, go with them. They need this win.
And let's see how Paul Westphal plays it. On the defensive end, Barkley has been matched with Cartwright, and the Bulls trying to get it to Cartwright. Williams with the rebound. Armstrong for three. B.J. Armstrong hitting on his third three-pointer. The Bulls now lead by eight.
You see a smart veteran Chicago team. They came down and saw that Charles Barkley was playing Scott Williams. So what they did is they played pick and roll with Pippen and Williams, knowing that Charles would have to switch on to Pippen, so he would try to pick up another foul.
Chambers knocked away from Cartwright. It'll be Chicago ball. The Bulls 63, the Suns 55. And now Barkley guarding Williams, who is not an offensive threat. For three-pointer. Johnson met by a double team and comes up hobbling. Looked like he got hit on the five. Barkley. Rebounded by Marley. And Marley getting inside. Chicago leads by six. 17 points for Marley. 3 minutes gone by in the third. Scott Williams.
I'm not so sure that's the shot that Phil Jackson wanted there out of Scott Williams. A little bit too excited right now.
Chambers. Bob Chambers continues to provide a lift for the Suns. The Bulls now lead by four. 10 points.
possession. Marley over the help. Shot clock at four. The ball deflected out by the Sun.
They are so concerned about B.J. Armstrong spotting up for a three-pointer. Richard Dumas, as soon as B.J. started to put it in the air, Dumas rotated out hard. B.J. takes the contact. Knows he's going to get the foul call.
And now Scott Williams left it. Trent Tucker, who has played well, checking in 3 for 3 for Trent in the first half in his 6 minutes of play. Chicago going to the three-guard set.
That substitution of Scott Williams was just so that Bill could give him a little reminder that he wants them staying within the offense, execute, don't take hurried shots.
Oh, beautiful move by Pippen. Post-up move by Scottie Pippen. The Bulls lead by 6. 17 points for Pippen. Tucker over, trying to steal it, but step down.
You don't see Scottie Pippen post up a whole lot during the regular season, but he can be effective down there as well. He backs the rookie Richard Dumas down and then just shoots the layup off the glass.
Matchup now is Trent Tucker guarding Dan Marley. Chambers! Well, Tom Chambers showing the entire repertoire, and he cuts it to a 4-point Chicago lead.
You have to admire Tom Chambers for stepping up in a situation where they really need him. Westbrook foul, Barkley with foul, Barkley not scoring a lot, and B.J. Armstrong hits a jump shot. Chambers has come in and provided him with the offensive scoring.
Dumas! Devin Johnson with the assist. 67-63. Chicago. Pippen. Rebound, Chambers. 5 minutes gone by in the third. Barkley getting position on Tucker, and a foul is called on Tucker.
Tom Chambers, who just secured the last defensive rebound, has come off the bench for Phoenix, provided a scoring lift, trying to help out Charles Barkley, who has struggled.
The crowd on its feet here at America West Arena. They see their sons make another run, move within four of the two-time defending champion Chicago Bulls. 6:56 remaining in the third. Bulls 67, Suns 63. Scott Williams is back. Charles Barkley tried to go at him and then threw it out. Here's Chambers. He's been hot. Johnson gets to it. Johnson! And again, Johnson keeps it alive. That was batted to the backcourt by Paxson, who just checked in. Kevin Johnson off the dribble, lost it. Barkley on the recovery.
If you say it to yourself, should Charles Barkley still be out there at this time, would you expect anything differently from Paul Westphal? They were down 0-2 against the Lakers, and he said, oh, no problem, we'll win the next three. The man believes in his team, he believes in Barkley.
It counts, and the foul. Pippen taking advantage of the mismatch on Johnson. Kevin Johnson tried to draw the charge, but it's called on Johnson.
Almost a strip by B.J., but good fortune for Phoenix. It winds up in Charles's hands, who has the finish. Then they find the mismatch. K.J. trying to play Pippen. K.J. tries to pick up the offensive foul by falling down. He's not going to get it. Pippen goes to the line now for the free throw opportunity.
Bulls by four, and Mike, as we saw time and time again in the Bulls series against the Knicks, when Michael Jordan went quiet, as he has, it has been Scottie Pippen who was able to add another dimension to his game, and Pippen has come through with a solid effort here tonight. Chambers open. Well, Tom Chambers set up beautifully the last couple of times down, but not able to convert. Paxson. Yes, that's a three-pointer for John Paxson. And the Bulls 8-for-11 in the three-point department. John Paxson hit 4 from three-point range in game 5. Chambers. He blew the stuff. Chicago leads That's his fourth three-pointer.
A double dose. This is the guy that used to start for Chicago and made so many big shots from behind the three-point line, John Paxson. This is the guy who has replaced him in the starting lineup, leads the NBA in three-point shooting. B.J. Armstrong, two different guys, same result.
Chicago leads by 10, 5:18 left in the third. Paul Westphal told Hannah Storm at halftime if the Bulls continue to hit the three-point shot as they did in the first half, it would be all over for the Phoenix Suns. Well, they have continued. They're 9 of 12 from three-point land. That ties the NBA Finals record, which was set by the Suns back in Game 3 when they were 9 for 13 in the three-point department. Kevin Johnson with a fling. Charles Barkley. So Barkley converts the funnel. The Bulls now lead 75-67 with just under 5 minutes remaining third quarter.
Charles finding another way to score. He can't get it off the direct entry pass. Goes after on the offensive board.
Pippen played by Marley. Scottie Pippen leaping for the rebound, but a loose ball foul was called. It's on Pippen, his third.
Charles Barkley sees KJ's a little bit off. He makes the extra effort. Scott Williams' job, keep a body on him. He doesn't do a good enough job. Charles finding a way to score, too.
Frank Johnson is back. Frank Johnson, Kevin Johnson, Danny Ainge, three-guard alignment, along with Charles Barkley and Dan Marley. That is a fouling violation. The ball goes back to the Bulls.
Frank Johnson that time had a wide-open jump shot. Catch, shoot the ball if you're open. Instead, he was trying to draw the defense and get down the lane. Took a step before he put it down.
Now Jordan posting up. Yes. Michael Jordan, 7 of 12. He has 20 points. Coming off a quiet second quarter. Kevin Johnson. Peter Charles Barkley. The Suns 69.
Violation of one of Chicago's defensive rules. No middle of the floor for Kevin Johnson because bad things happen when he gets down there.
Now the Suns with a 4-on-3. Bulls able to get back. Ainge going glass. It's a 6-point. Chicago lead. 8 points for Ainge. The height advantage with Kevin Johnson in the matchup. Jordan not able to go to the drive as frequently because of the quickness of Johnson, but still able to get the good looks on those turnarounds.
And the intelligence of Michael. He saw Marley coming from the middle of the floor to double team him late. He turned to the baseline again for the shot.
Michael Johnson was way off. That gets the crowd discussing the shot, although Frank Johnson has shot well in this series. 45 for man in the third quarter. They double up on Jordan. Pippen tried to draw contact and Barkley stepped away. Does not want to pick up his fifth foul. The Bulls again lead by 10. Our flag getting set to return. Illegal defense called for the first time.
Michael Jordan, the ability to recognize where the double team is coming from. He feels Danny Ainge coming from the top, so he spins to the left shoulder, shoots the fadeaway, hits it over Kevin Johnson. The next time on the other side of the floor, he sees Marley coming late, so he turns to the right shoulder, elevates over Kevin Johnson. The ability to read the defense and make the right decision. Michael Jordan, the best.
Mark West checking back in. Timeout has been taken with 2:19. Remaining this third quarter, the Bulls with a 10-point lead. This is game number 6 of the best of 7. Game 7, if necessary, here in Phoenix on Wednesday. Recapping, it was a victory for the Bulls here in Phoenix in game 1 as Michael Jordan led the way with 31. Game 2, Jordan with 42. And the Bulls won it 111-108. First time in NBA Finals history that a team had won
two straight, or the first two on the road. And then in Chicago, the Suns able to get back into it by winning two out of the three at Chicago Stadium, including that triple overtime classic, Dan Marley with six from three-point range. And then in game four, Jordan with 55 points, and the Bulls won 111 to 105. In game five this past Friday night, Charles Barkley with 24, Richard Dumas had the hot hand, 12 of 14 from the field for his 25, and another strong game for Kevin Johnson as the Suns won by 10 points. For Phoenix, their best overall showing of the playoffs on Friday night as they led most of the way, led by as many as 16 in the first quarter. No team has ever come back from a 3-1 deficit to win an NBA championship series. The goal of the Phoenix Suns. Horace Grant checking back in after the one-point game on Friday. He has managed just to match it here tonight, and he's playing with four fouls. This after very strong play earlier in the series.
You're talking about 2 points for Horace Grant in the last seven quarters of basketball.
The Chicago Bulls trying to become only the third team in the history of the NBA to win three in a row. No one has done it in 26 years. Only the Minneapolis Lakers and the Boston Celtics have won three in a row. Kevin Johnson in the foul. Johnson with the drive, and he was hanged. Foul committed by P.J. Armstrong, his third.
Try to keep Kevin Johnson out of the middle of the floor. The problem is when they start him off with the basketball in the middle, he can go right, he can go left. It's tough to guess which way. Most times, scouting report says he likes that crossover right to left. BJ trying to play him for it, but give Kevin credit. He is so good at it. Even when you know it's coming, it's tough to stop.
11.7 assists for Kevin Johnson. Chicago leads by 7. 2 minutes 20 in the third. Gave Grant the shot. Jordan. Rebound Barkley off the box out.
Michael Jordan has no field goals inside, layups or dunks. Right now he is 8 for 15 from the outside.
Kevin Johnson.
Horace Grant may not have many points tonight, but that time he did one of the subtle things. Put a big body on there, blocked out, let his teammate Scott Williams go get the basketball.
Pippen going to the left hand and switch to the right. A gorgeous move by Scottie Pippen. The drive to the left, and then he was able to change up to hit the shot with the right hand. And the Bulls now lead 83-74. And that, an illegal defense for the second time, leading to the technical foul. Danny Ainge will shoot the technical. Charles Barkley will sit down. Oliver Miller is back. Barkley 16 points, 10 rebounds.
Here's where the illegal defense takes place. Barkley has the ball guarded by one man. Michael Jordan will start to come and stop right about here, then tries to get going again. You can't do that. It must be an aggressive double team. Stop, go, illegal defense. Aggressive is the key to it.
E.J. Armstrong replaced by John Paxson. Bulls lead by 8. 1 minute left in the third quarter. Nice lead pass. Johnson for Miller. Chicago 83 and Phoenix 77. Well, the Bulls have been able to pull away the double-figure leads on several occasions, but have not been able to put the Suns away. Phoenix continues to come back at them. Shot clock at 4. Michael Jordan is 9 for 16. He has 24 points.
Excellent job. Chicago saw there were 50 seconds remaining when they got the ball. They knew they could run it down as far as possible, and still, if they get a stop, we get one more possession, 2-for-1 situation to end the quarter.
Johnson around Jordan, and foul. Kevin Johnson. Johnson with a beautiful dribble drive to beat Michael Jordan.
We had talked about that right-to-left crossover that they play for. Michael anticipating he was going to go right-left. Instead, KJ gave him the fake, kept it in his right hand, saw the alley, down the lane. Michael trying to get the strip from behind.
Jordan called for his third. Johnson is one of one from the line. Now B.J. Armstrong and Brent Tucker check back in. Phil Jackson looking for the long range effect as they will hold to set up for the final shot with this third quarter winding down. Mark West sitting down. Richard Dumas will come on for Oliver Miller. .17 remaining in the third quarter. A game that has seen the Bulls do it with the three-point shot. They've hit 9 of 12 from downtown. Armstrong has hit 4-4-5. Jordan 3 of 5 from downtown.
Phoenix may go for a hard foul steal in the situation because they do have a foul to give, so you may want to gamble here. Go for it quickly, see if you come up with the ball without fouling, but don't let them get a good shot. There's the foul.
And that the foul to give. It's on Marley, only his first. So the Bulls will inbound with 9 seconds remaining in this third quarter.
Smart move by Michael. He knew they had a foul to give, so he went early enough to make them commit the foul and still have a lot of time left now to run something down.
Tucker. Trent Tucker hits again. 1 3/10 seconds remaining in the quarter. Dumas had to be careful. Wide. Trent Tucker off the bench to hit 4 out of 4 from the field for 9 points. After 3, it's the Bulls 87 and the Suns 79. We'll be back after these messages and a word from your local station.
It's a silver time. It's a silver play. Silver setting at a silver face.
Waiting for
our very best friends.
So silver bullet through.
They never end.
In a silver time.
Good light.
In a silver place.
So write me now.
Silver memory.
Ovation for the Suns as they step back onto the floor. Happy Father's Day from all of us at NBC Sports. As we head to the fourth quarter in Chicago, leading Phoenix 87-79. The Bulls hoping to wrap the series in this, the sixth game. Phoenix looking to force it to a seventh and final game here on Wednesday night. It is Phoenix ball as this fourth quarter gets underway. Barkley up front with West and Dumas. Pauley and Johnson at the guards. Double team. Pippen came over, left Dumas open. Dumas not able to hit the outside shot tonight. Marley. And the Suns regroup. Darrell Garrison indicating a leg lock. Kicking violation. Called on Pippen, so Phoenix maintains possession and they get a new 24. It has been an odd series. The Bulls are 7-1 on the road in the finals the last 3 years, and only 4 up, 4 down at home. Barkley, Cartwright with the rebound.
I would not be surprised to see the basketball go in Charles Barkley's hands 80-85% of the time here in this fourth quarter. Let Charles go, let him make a decision, score, pass to open teammates. Be the starter for their offense.
Shot clock at 4. Oh, Pippen. Here's Jordan. And Marley moves it back.
The only reason Michael shot that one is because he didn't know whether they were going to give him a reset or not on that shot attempt. He thought the shot clock may have been run down, so he was just trying to get it up there quickly.
Oh, Kevin Johnson landing on his left hand as he was fouled. Bulls have gone cold. As this fourth quarter opens up, they finish strong at the end of the third.
Keeping him in one direction, not letting him cross over. The foul on BJ, the hard fall by KJ.
Armstrong called for his fourth four-piece on Armstrong and Grant. Barkley has been playing with four, as has West. Kevin Johnson is 4-for-4 from the line. He's an 82% free throw shooter. 18 points for Armstrong, who has done it with the three-point shot. Kevin Johnson has had another solid game. His first good one, though, here in Phoenix. Bulls 87, Suns 81. Minute and a half gone by in the fourth quarter. Again, it's Barkley guarding Cartwright. West rejects. Dumas in the open floor, and he stopped. Armstrong stopped the ball. Here's West, and a foul call.
When Bill Cartwright started to make his move against Barkley, Charles backed off. Cartwright started to stumble. Mark West comes over and gives help from the blind side. Clean block. Then back at the other end, reward the guy that just made the big defensive play. Give it to West down low. Gets fouled by big Bill Cartwright.
To the successful free throw by Mark West, who is only a 52% foul shooter. The Bulls by five. Phil Jackson has a front line of Conway with Grant and Pippen, Jordan and Armstrong in the backcourt. Bulls with their starting lineup on the floor. Pippen. West with the back tap. Johnson accelerates. Jordan able to stay in front of him.
Good job by Michael of moving his feet, and then he did not give the ball back to Kevin Johnson.
Barkley directs traffic. Barkley backing Grant. Barkley changed his mind. Chicago will talk it over.
The reason that Barkley was able to convert the pass is that Dumas came to meet the basketball. He shortened the pass between Barkley and the next receiver. By meeting it, it did not allow Jordan or anyone else to intercept it by shooting the gap.
Danny Ainge and the rest of the Suns reacting. Phoenix has moved within three.
Dan O'Brien?
Okay, Dan. I'll show you to your truck.
Do our new computerized reservations make renting from Ryder faster than ever?
What's that name again? Dave!
No contest.
Miller Genuine Draft presents Genuine Moments.
This Miller moment takes us back to the 1977 finals, where Blazer Mania struck Portland. Julius Erving and the Philadelphia 76ers jumped off to a 2-0 lead in the series, but Bill Walton, Maurice Lucas led the Trailblazers back to sweep the next four. The Blazers thus became the second of only two teams to overcome a 2-0 deficit and capture an NBA championship. In recognition of this moment, Miller Genuine Draft will donate $1,000 to the Thurgood Marshall Scholarship Fund. And the Phoenix Suns are trying to come back from a 3-1 deficit to win an NBA championship series. They've come back from an 11-point deficit here tonight to move within three. 9:20 remaining in the fourth quarter. Bulls having difficulty locating the shot. We're down to five on the 24. We're down to three. Down to one. Pippen. Mike Mathis waves it off. 24 second violation.
You can see they're a little bit out of sync right now.
Pippen tries to elevate up. The ball in his hands when it's double zero. It's got to be out of it. Very close call that time, whether it had been released off the fingertips or was still in.
Barkley coming up short. Ball's back to the offense. Michael Jordan getting a rest at this point. Paxson. Down to five on the 24. Down to three. Down to one. It's Grant. Another excellent defensive sequence by the Suns. And it will be Phoenix back in possession.
I can tell you this much, the rest that Michael Jordan is getting will be a very short rest. He's why, when the shot clock is running down, Chicago gets so many good shot opportunities, because he's a creator. He's a guy that makes things happen off the dribble.
Barkley backing, draws a double team, forced it, West fields it, and he draws the foul. Cartwright collects his fourth.
That was number 34, Horace Grant.
No, they change it. It's Horace Grant committing the foul. That is his fifth.
Grant gets the first foul as Cartwright comes from behind it. Good call. First one initiated by Grant on the arm.
West, one of two from the line.
Number 23, Michael Jordan.
And as we mentioned earlier, a poor free throw shooter. Here's Michael Jordan back. A.J. Armstrong sitting down. The Suns are 25-29 from the free throw line. The West hits one out of two. And the Suns are down by only 2 points. In the fourth quarter, it will be Phoenix ball. The double team on Barkley. Paxson shooting over. Barkley with the spin and a foul call. Charles Barkley to the line.
Chicago is trying not to have to come and double team early to get the ball out of Charles's hands. But if it continues this way, they let him back down to the point where he can go either middle or baseline. They just can't get to him in time. They will continue to have to foul him.
Barkley, 6 of 8 from the line. Cartwright, as you saw, called for the foul. That is 4 on Cartwright. 17 points for Barkley. And he can tie the game right here.
That man, Phil Jackson, sensing that the team might be tightening up right now, trying to sit down, remain calm, get everybody back under control, hope they can execute against the Phoenix pressure, which has really picked up in the last couple minutes.
Well, the Bulls maintain the one-point lead. Pippen. Paxson for three. And Chicago will get a new 24. The Bulls in this fourth quarter are 0-7.
You can see it, Mark. You can see that the shots are all short. They're pulling that string on the shot. This is a very, very critical stretch right here for Chicago to somehow find a way of getting an easy basket.
Jordan in a one-on-one is fouled. He was trying to set up the crossover, and Marley bumped him. Well, Phil Jackson telling us before the game that he felt that the Bulls were tense in the fourth quarter in Game 5 on Friday, as you watched the foul called on Marley. He felt they were short-arming from the foul line and also from the field. And we may be seeing that right here.
Let's go back to what we said earlier about the temperature in the building, the tempo, the fatigue factor.
Paxson passed on the shot. Pippen. Rebound Marler. The Bulls by one. Phoenix with a chance to take the lead. West pops it out.
Jordan had only one thought in mind that time. Get to the rim and jump into someone and draw contact. We've got to find a way to put some easy points on the scoreboard, is his thinking.
On NBC is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By AT&T, the official telecommunications company of the NBA. And by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft. Get out of the old, get into the cold.
The Gorilla leading the Cheers here in Phoenix with 5:51 remaining in this fourth quarter. Horace Grant missing the easy opportunity, lost the grip on the ball. And the Bulls to this point 0 for the fourth quarter. They have not scored in the fourth. They're 0 for 9 from the field. Suns not burning it up, 1 for 7, but they managed to hit on foul shots, so they've outscored Chicago 7-0. Jordan to the line.
Number 42, Scott Williams, returns to the Bulls lineup for 54 Horace Grant.
And Horace Grant will sit down. The last time Chicago scored was a John Paxson jump shot at the buzzer to end the third. They've gone 6 minutes and 10 seconds without scoring a point before that Michael Jordan foul shot.
Little offense, defense for Phil Jackson. Tate ran out trying to save another personal foul on him, put Scott Williams in to defend against Barkley.
Barkley off the fake. The Suns. The Bulls 90, the Suns 88. Marley for three. The Suns lead 91-90. First time they've led since early when they were up by the score of 16-14. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the fourth. Here is Jordan. Yes. Michael Jordan answers. The Bulls 92 and the Suns 91.
When you saw Phil Jackson talking to Paxson, I've got a feeling that he's anticipating Phoenix sees Michael heating up. They're going to go double a little earlier. He wants shooters in the spot-up areas that can break their back if they go and double Michael.
Scott Williams jumps out on a switch. Pocket five, Barkley for three. Back tap by Barkley. Aim. Rebound West. Rebound. Phoenix, 93. Chicago, 92. Jordan from deep. Way off. Marley met by Armstrong at a switch. Just under 4 minutes. Stepping up for the jumper. Marley with the tip. And a loose ball foul is called on the ball.
Charles Barkley after timeout.
Peat likes to play from the top of the circle so he can ball fake and drive left or right. A strong move to the basket by Charles. And then down 2 points, Marley pulls up from behind the three-point line to give Phoenix a one-point lead.
Fifth, Chicago over the limit. The Suns have only two team fouls. Barkley sitting down. So five apiece. I should say Cartwright sitting down. Five apiece on Cartwright and Grant. Suns 27 for 33 from the line. Marley is 4 for 5. Phoenix 94. Chicago 92. The Suns with the season on the line, hoping to send it to a seventh game here on Wednesday. Net of defense. Jordan had it knocked away. Shot clock at 3. Pippen back for Jordan. Airball fielded by Marley, and that's a 24-second violation. And Michael Jordan has been out of sync in the second half.
Jordan gets down in the low post again, but the quick hand of KJ strips him of the ball. Now it's a matter of can he get it up before the clock runs out. In his haste, Michael shoots it over the top. 24-second violation.
Timeout called by Chicago. Welcome you back to Phoenix, Arizona, where the Suns have come from behind to take a 94-92 lead off the Chicago Bulls with 3:20 remaining in the game. And the Suns have outscored the Bulls 15-5 here in the fourth quarter. Bulls went 6 minutes and 10 seconds without scoring a point. And the two-time defending champion Bulls look to be very tight. That's the case in Chicago on Friday night.
One of the things is that their offense relies on passing of the basketball. Marley with the 3. Buckley comes up with another offensive rebound. They rely on throwing passes, but they're not getting into the offense quickly enough. As a result, the clock is running out on them.
Kevin Johnson, yes. Suns 96, the Bulls 92. Scott Williams tied up. Or foul, let's see. It is a foul. It is number 5 on Barkley.
Try to keep Kevin Johnson out of the middle of the lane. One of the rules of the Chicago Bulls, sometimes easier said than done. Charles trying for the jump ball situation. Instead, foul is called.
5 on Barkley. With much time remaining. 2:45. A double up on Jordan. Michael Jordan cuts it to a 2-point Phoenix lead. 31 for Jordan.
Is there any doubt where they want the basketball to go? You got to rely on the guy that can put the money in the bank for you.
Armstrong called for that retreat.
Michael Jordan took the first double team, kicked it back outside. Then they go right back into him again. He knows that he's got time if he turns quickly to get it up over Kevin Johnson before Marley can return and trap him again.
Five fouls apiece on Armstrong, Grant, and Cartwright. Kevin Johnson to the foul line. He's 5 out of 5 from the line. He's an 82% free throw shooter. Kevin Johnson coming up strong once again. 17 points and 10 assists. And they are chanting KJ. 2:23 remaining fourth quarter. Phoenix leads by 3 points. The Suns, 98. The Bulls, 94. Scottie Pippen setting it up.
for a second. And the Bulls offense is completely out of sync.
It's a classic case of the defense of Phoenix not allowing the guards to handle the basketball, BJ and Paxson, to get him into their offense. As a result, Pippen's brought it down the floor the last couple times and not getting into their offense until 11 or 10 left on the 24-second clock. Then there's just not a lot of time to run the intricate cuts and patterns that they're used to running.
Suns with the ball and a four-point lead. Barkley backing in. Rebound West. A loose ball foul is called on West. He's called for a push.
Loose ball foul number 21.
That is five on West. For the Suns, their 14th foul, so the Bulls will not go to the line.
When the shot goes up, West fighting for position, hooks Horace Grant. No question about it, there's a foul as he follows it up for a tip-in.
I'll take it. Minute 46 remaining of the game. When we come back, it will be Chicago ball.
Some in the U.S. Army then.
Chicago at one point led by as many as 11. Chicago with only 7 points in the fourth quarter, outscored by Phoenix 19-7. The Bulls shooting 3 of 15 here in the fourth. Michael Jordan has all 7 Bulls points. While Chicago was getting the balanced attack earlier, they have not been getting much help offensively. As Paxson starts up, Suns by 4, a minute 40 to go in the fourth.
Talked about fourth quarter fatigue, 7 points for Chicago.
Jordan and Johnson in possession. Now Phoenix, I would think, would want to play the clock a bit here. A minute 20 to go. 15 on the shot clock. Ainge trying to draw the foul. Shot clock at 5. Marley from way out. And nearly got the roll. Rebounded by Barkley. Charles Barkley calling for the timeout. A sensational play by Barkley.
That rebound was number 17 for Charles Barkley. That's what he told his coach he was going to do before the game. I'm getting you 17. He certainly has to work hard to get this one. The ball almost bounces in. The presence, the ball, timeout before the turnover takes place.
That's the second time he's been able to call a timeout while in flight. Paul Westphal enjoying it. Charles Barkley with a 17th rebound, and it was an enormous one.
Look at the range that Marley shoots this shot from. Jordan tries to get out and challenge it. And as deep as it is, it almost still goes in. Then Barkley hustles after it, chases it down, calls timeout. And when you look at Paul Westphal, still finding humor in the moment as Marley's coming off. Westphal gives him the choke sign, signaling that he should have made that shot.
Phoenix Suns ball club, and they maintain possession off that timeout call by Barkley. We're just under 1 minute remaining in this fourth quarter. Suns lead 98-94. Ainge pitches back to Frank Johnson, rebounded by Michael Jordan. Frank Johnson, not the man that the Suns would have wanted to take that shot, and Jordan is able to go the distance.
Worst thing that could happen, let him score and use up very few precious seconds. So now, if they can get a defensive stop without fouling, Chicago will have a chance to tie the game.
2 point, Phoenix lead, 25 seconds to go, 10 on the shot clock. Pippen over to help. Marley eluding Jordan. Frank Johnson gives it back. Marley, oh, he went short. It's a 24-second violation. Let's see. Ed Rush and Mike Mathis conferring. Apparently, Chicago had called for time. The 24-second violation buzzer did go off. Darryl Garrison giving the indication that it was a violation.
When Michael Jordan came up with the basketball, he looked up the floor, saw a clear path to the basket. Nobody moved over to stop him. They certainly didn't want to foul and give him a three-point play. So he scores and uses very little time.
13 and 6/10 seconds remaining in the fourth. The Suns by two. It will be Chicago in possession. 4/10 of a second now remaining in this fourth quarter.
And what the official is saying is that there was a shot clock violation first that took place, then the timeout.
And they just made another adjustment. 14 and 1/10 seconds remaining. Well, the Suns have shot only 41% from the field, but they have done it at the foul line, 30 of 36. They've also done it with 17 offensive rebounds. However, the Suns, with a chance to ice the game, have missed six of their last seven shots. So the Bulls have been able to come back. In this fourth quarter, though, Chicago with a mere 9 points. They've been outscored 19-9. The NBA Finals record, fewest points in the fourth quarter, 13. Michael Jordan has scored all 9 Chicago points here in the fourth. 9 of his 33. The Suns by two. It has come down to this possession.
They want Michael to get a full head of steam, try to keep him in the middle of the floor.
Well, Pippen got the snap. Here's Paxson for three. Yes, the Bulls take a 1-point lead, and Phoenix calls for time with 3 9/10 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. John Paxson converts a 3-pointer in Chicago 99 and Phoenix 98.
They've done this at least 3 or 4 times in the game. Penetrated and thrown backwards to a man rotating back to a spot-up area. There's the man, John Paxson. Grant gets the ball out to the right man at the right spot, and from the time it leaves his hand, it's perfect rotation on the basketball. He feels it. The team loves it as they run back to the bench on the timeout.
And that is an NBA Finals record 10th three-pointer by Chicago. They've hit 10 of 14 from three-point land. For Paxson, his second. He hit 4 in game 5. And now Paul Westphal setting it up with 3 9/10 seconds to go. We'll be right back. For the Chicago Bulls, right here, the only points scored by anyone aside from Michael Jordan as they kick it back out to John Paxson. The field goal by Paxson from three-point land, the only points in the fourth quarter by a Bull aside from Jordan. And the Bulls lead by 1.
Remember, 3.9 seconds remaining is a lot of time. Chicago has a delay of game to use, so they may try and let Scott Williams run over the sideline to get a look at this play, expose it so they know how better to defend it. Plenty of time for Phoenix to put it on the floor, take it to the basket, create a shot either for the dribbler or someone else spotting up.
And a 20-second timeout was taken by Chicago. So the Bulls checked it out, and we'll talk about the defensive scheme. The Bulls have 1 full timeout remaining. The Suns have a 20 left. The Bulls are over the foul limit. Oliver Miller checking in. It's Miller, Marley, Barkley, Ainge, and Johnson on the floor.
Charles Barkley has made a number of gigantic shots from the middle of the floor, top of the circle area. That's where they like to get him. He loves stepping back right from there and shooting a jumper. He must have won a half dozen games in Philadelphia with shots at the end from that area.
For the Suns, the season has come down to this, and now they take the delay of game. So another look for Phil Jackson.
Sneak preview on what they were trying to run. Now a substitution. Phil Jackson brings John Paxson into the basketball game. They want him to match up on Ainge. They want Williams out for a more mobile defensive team.
seconds to go. Evan Johnson will inbound. Oliver Miller plays it. Here's Johnson. Johnson gets, no, he could not get it all knocked away by Grant. It's all over. The Chicago Bulls have three straight NBA championships. A three-point shot by John Paxson, the game winner. The Bulls with a record low, only 12 points. In the fourth quarter, that was an NBA Finals record low, but it was enough.
Michael Jordan, when that buzzer went off, first jump so high, but immediately had the presence to chase the basketball down into the crowd. Whoever had picked it up, he wanted that basketball, signifying the third world championship in a row, and he went after it and got it.
And Paul Westphal heads back to the locker room. A disappointing finish for the Suns, who had rallied and taken the lead but could not put it away. And Horace Grant, a man who has struggled the last two games, he comes up with the block to conclude matters.
Talk about the block. He did the last two things that mattered the most. He threw the pass back out to John Paxson for the shot. He gets that assist. He gets the block on that last shot attempt to preserve the victory.
So the Chicago Bulls have accomplished something that has not been done in 27 years. They have become only the fourth team in NBA history to win three in a row. No team has done it. In the last 26 years, only the Minneapolis Lakers and the Boston Celtics have won three straight titles. The two most recent teams to attempt it, the 1989 Lakers, the 1991 Pistons, both falling short. And this crowd has been stunned by that finish.
This goes back to the timeout where the Chicago coaches put the ball in Jordan's hands. You thought he was going to take it the length of the floor, but instead they suddenly flashed Scottie Pippen up to the top of the circle. Pippen takes it off the dribble, heads to the basket, kicks out to Grant, who could have gone up strong to try and tie the game. Instead, Grant has the presence to throw the ball back out to a wide-open John Paxson. No one can get to him in time, and that champion's attitude. Go for the win rather than the tie on the road. So give Horace Grant credit for turning and kicking out. And then, when it seems that he's beat, the recovery by Grant to block the shot from behind Kevin Johnson's head. Michael Jordan jumps, but then says, I want this basketball. He is off into the stands right now, gathering the basketball.
And shades of game five, the Bulls against the Knicks, with Charles Smith having the four opportunities to convert. And the Bulls, with the combination of Grant and Pippen, were able to stop Smith. They come up with the defensive play right here. Michael Jordan, the high man, with 33. Charles Barkley had 21, along with 17 rebounds. And the Bulls are still undefeated at America West Arena. They won during the course of the regular season, and they won three straight in the playoffs. What an unusual series this has been, with the Bulls winning the first two here in Phoenix, and then Chicago having their props at home. Phoenix winning two out of three at Chicago Stadium.
I think it's just a credit to the inner strength of both of these teams to be able to go on the road and win the big basketball games that they had to win to give themselves a chance to survive in this series. You think it's over early when Chicago takes the first two in this building, and then Phoenix goes back into the stadium, makes a few adjustments, grows as a team, suddenly walks out of there with two victories. Now the momentum swings. They work all year to get home court advantage with 62 wins, have games 6 and 7 here. And what does Chicago do? Find the inner strength to come back and win the game they had to win here. I don't know anyone that wanted on Chicago's team to let it go to 7 and take a chance.
And Mike, following tonight, we are czarless for all of us here at NBC Sports. We wish you the very best, a terrific 3 years for you, and the very best for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Remember, if things don't work out here at NBC, there are many behind-the-scenes type jobs with the proper
giving it the proper time, I think that we'd accept you back.
I appreciate the encouragement all along, the 3 years of solid encouragement.
So the Czar heads to Cleveland. The Chicago Bulls are in the midst of celebrating. And we will have the trophy presentation that is coming up shortly. The Bulls make it 3 in a row. We'll be right back.
The NBA on NBC is brought to you by Miller Genuine Draft, who salutes the back-to-back-to-back NBA World Champion Chicago Bulls.
Miller Genuine Draft and the back-to-back-to-back NBA World Champion Chicago Bulls. Making the world a very cool place.
And amid the bedlam of the visitors' locker room in Phoenix, we have virtually the entire roster of the three-time champions, and David Stern will attempt to make the presentation. Go ahead, Commissioner.
Three-time NBA world champion Chicago Bulls. Congratulations. It's a great accomplishment.
Michael will allow you to speak first on behalf of your teammates.
Well, I think everybody put their effort out there. You know, from Corey Williams to Ed Neal, all the guys that were going to injury reserve. You know, this is a hard-fought three-peat. You know what I mean? It took a lot of work. A lot of times it looked down at them, but we stuck in there, we hung together as a team, and, you know, this is a reward of what the hard work does for you.
Thank you. The crowd here kind of blocks us from seeing the monitor. We'll try, but until Pax's winning three-pointer, you had all the points for the Bulls in the fourth quarter.
I knew Pax was going to make that. I just knew it whenever he got it. It was a great draw in, and, you know, for my part, I just try to do whatever I can. I hope you enjoy it, Bob. It feels good right now.
Is it joy or is it relief or is it a combination? This has been a great year but a tough year.
It's both. You know, it's a relief. Plus, it's great to win. You know, I think we've gone through a lot. Me, personally, I've gone through a lot of ups and downs. But to cap it off this way means a lot to me, believe me.
I hate to make you look ahead, but you've talked about retirement in a year or two. Could you step aside if the streak is still intact?
No. You know, my love is strong for this game right now. That's how I'm looking at it. And I'm going to be here as long as my love is strong.
We're going to roll in some of the plays from the fourth quarter. I don't know if we'll be able to see them. Try and make a little space here, guys, for Michael to take a look. And the one that I'd specifically like to talk about, and we'll get to it in a minute, would be your last basket. They're up by four when Frankie Johnson misses a jump shot, and they let you go the length of the floor, used up very little time, and they never touched you.
I don't think anybody saw me. You know, I think once I got the rebound, everybody was running to the three-point shooters. You know, I just kept putting pressure on the defense. And right before I get to go to the basket for the layup, Scottie Pippen grabs Marley, which you can't get to the basket and try to stop me. So that was a big play.
Now, on the last play, you had to give it up in the backcourt. Never touched it in shooting range. Pippen gave it to Horace and then back to Pax.
Well, the plan was to get the ball to me, and get it to Scotty, and cut off of Scotty. If I can get the ball back. But he turned it around, gave it to Horace, and then Horace kicked it back out to Paxson. And once I saw Paxson get the basketball, I knew it was good.
Where is John Paxson? Where's Pax?
Get in here, Pax.
Move him in here.
Go, Pat.
A couple of years ago, you scored 10 points on clutch jumpers in Los Angeles and what turned out to be the winner. You had a big fourth quarter against Portland as well in the sixth game last year, and now the shot that wins the championship.
Yeah, this is a dream. What can I say? Maybe we were the ones destined to win after all. It was, what a great feeling. I can't describe what I feel.
Before we continue, Michael, I know you want to jump down. This has been, in many ways, your year with the Dream Team and with the certification in the minds of most now as the greatest to ever play the game. A final thought on what this means to you and your team.
Well, I think it means a lot to us. I mean, because we make history. Very few teams have done this. You know, especially when so much parity in the league right now, this is a major accomplishment for the franchise and for the team. And, you know, for me personally, you know, I think it's something that I was looking forward to separate myself from Magic and Bird. They never did it, and I did it. So that makes me, you know, feel special, I believe it.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
All right, let's go back to Pax. When it left your hand, your thoughts? I mean, you had the stroke going, no doubt about it.
I don't know. I mean, that's instinct. You catch and you shoot. I've done it hundreds of thousands of times in my life. So Horace gave me a good pass. We struggled that fourth quarter. I'm just glad I could do something about it.
You were spotting up the whole play. That was obvious. You just went to that spot.
Right. I was going to stay behind the three-point line in case something happened, and the ball just fell in the horse's hands. I got it. Unbelievable. I'm glad Chicago's got a third one. We're a city of champions.
Congratulations, John.
Bob, I appreciate it.
All right, we'll be back, and we'll talk with Phil Jackson. Oh, wait, Michael has an additional thought. Go ahead.
This is for Jasmine, my sweet little daughter.
Who you with?
Happy birthday, Jazz.
And happy Father's Day to Michael Jordan. All right, Trent Tucker's here, Darryl Walker, Horace Grant, Bill Cartwright, Scottie Pippen. We'll talk with the coach, Phil Jackson. But first, let's go over to the Phoenix locker room. Paul Westfall is with Hannah Storm.
Coach, a great effort by your team, and you came so close to taking this to a seventh game. Can you describe what happened on the final play when John Paxson sunk the three-pointer?
Well, it was just a spread court situation. They tried to take it to the basket, and Mark West had to leave Horace Grant to go help on the penetration, and Danny Ainge thought that he might be able to pick the pass off, and instead of throwing it to Grant, he turned and passed it back to Pippen, who was wide open. I mean, back to Paxson, who was wide open. Seemed like that ball was in the air for about an hour, and he made the shot. It's a great shot. You got to give him credit. It's something every kid dreams about, and John Paxson got to live that dream out.
Coach, what about the dreams of your team? I know that they are very disappointed. What did you tell them after the loss?
Well, I wasn't real articulate. I just told them that I was very proud of them, that they gave me everything that they had, and that they lost to a great team.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations on a great season in your first year, and we'll see you next year. Bob?
All right, thank you, Hannah. We just heard Paul Westfall say, Phil, we lost to a great team. I think it was better, for history's sake, now that you got it, that they proved to be such a stern test.
Well, we never could get a hold of this basketball club. You know, we've always been able to defend somebody, put the claws on them, and hold them down. We couldn't hold this team down. They found ways to squiggle out, and they came back at you all the time. We had a nice lead. All of a sudden, their defense took over in the fourth quarter. We were so fortunate to come out of that game with an opportunity win.
You know, you scored 12 points in the fourth quarter. That's the lowest fourth quarter in a final since the advent of the 24-second clock, and you got away with it.
Isn't that amazing? We got away in one. We had 5 points with 3-something left on the clock. I told the guys, we'll find a way to win. We'll get this thing over. If you'll play defense, we'll do it. And they did it. It's great.
How tough was this year for you with Michael and Scotty coming off the dream team, guys tired perhaps mentally as well as physically?
Well, we submitted a record for the fact that we wanted guys healthy in the playoffs, and it worked for us. And when you got Scotty and Michael and Horace and the guys that have played together as a crew, you got a great chance to win the playoffs. Those are great guys to coach, regardless of the energy level. We might have coasted a little bit this year, but we had to, and we got away with it. We came into the playoffs full bore, ready to go.
I know talk about all-time great teams is a parlor game, but you played on one of them in the Knicks and against great teams of that era, and you coached one of them and against them, so you have a good perspective. Where does this club rank?
Well, with Michael Jordan, you just step above everybody else because he's got such a will to win. He's so competitive, he helps everybody out to the nth degree. And that's what makes this team very, very special, is they've got a guy, a leader, that's a great competitor. They've got some great veterans like a Paxson, a Bill, and Horace, and Scotty that fit together well, and BJ came on this year. And some guys off the bench that play their role. But he has lifted us to another level.
So the Suns made you miss the Grateful Dead concert in Chicago this weekend, but in a sense, it's a Grateful Dead here. Grateful for the title and probably dead tired, huh?
You bet. They've been playing for 30 years. I can see them the next 30 years, too.
Congratulations, Phil.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay. Let's turn here to Horace Grant. Certainly offensively not a factor in the last couple of games, but the key block toward the end with Kevin Johnson on the final play, and we'll try to clear the monitor here so Horace can get a look at it, and the pass out to Pax for the winner.
Well, my our free throw shooting wasn't going right, but there's the block right there. You know, I just wanted to get a hand up, and I got the ball.
Did Barkley wear you out playing him at the defensive end? Did that hurt you offensively?
I mean, I'm not an offensive player now, but Barkley, you know, it really would wear anybody out. You know, it had a toll on me at the end.
Scottie Pippen, you sliced down the lane on that last possession. It looked like the shot might have been yours. Then Horace was open, baseline, and he kicked it back out.
Well, I felt like the Horace was going to be open. I felt like his man was stepping in the lane, and I gave him the ball. I thought he was going to take it and finish it, but John Paxson was right there, right open. I mean, what more can you say?
No one can ever be the number one guy on this team except Michael Jordan, but in two consecutive clinchers, the fourth quarter against Portland in Game 6 last year in Chicago, and here with the 23 points on the 12 boards, you have made a key contribution, and in the Knicks series, you came up big when it was needed. So you've established yourself at a certain level.
Our main focus is to go out and play hard and play our game and do what you can do on the court. Mike is going to be Michael. Mike is going to get his 40, 50 points, but the rest of us contributed. We can do what we accomplished today. And tell me the truth. Did we just win three?
You just won three. Got to ask you one last thing. Barkley was really woofing at you. What was being said?
Well, he was talking trash, telling me, you guys going to be here to win. Steve, you guys going to be here to win. So you want to come over for dinner. So I'm going to invite him to Chicago for dinner. Chicago!
Let's turn to Bill Cartwright. At age 35, now the third in a row, they must become more and more precious because the sand is moving through the hourglass.
Oh, no question. It's just unbelievable. A lot of pressure on us to win, to get it done. They're really kind of loose. And I tell you, it was just unbelievable effort. Huge shot by Pax to get it done. And here we are.
You played countless basketball games. You can tell us the truth about this one. When they had the ball up by four in less than a minute to go, do you think you were coming back here Wednesday?
There was a little doubt, but, you know, anytime you have Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, and Pax will shoot the tar of the basketball, you got a big chance. So this was a huge game for us and for me, and I'm thrilled to death. I want to say hello to my boys back home and my daughter, Kristen.
And a happy Father's Day as Will Perdue does the dowsing of Bill Cartwright. Let's go over to the other side, much different atmosphere. KJ with Hannah Storm.
Kevin, it was such a competitive series, perhaps even more competitive than the final records will indicate, 4-2. What was the difference in the end, do you think, between the two teams?
I thought this last ball game was a great ball game. I thought it could have went either way. They got a pretty big cushion for three quarters, but we hung in there and cut the lead down in the fourth quarter. And they just made some big shots when they needed it. And, you know, certainly they deserve it, and you got to give them a lot of credit.
KJ, a lot of people made the incorrect assumption that the NBA Finals will be played in the East between the Knicks and the Bulls. Do you think that the Phoenix Suns, by the way that they played in the Finals, gained a measure of respect?
Well, I think our play spoke for itself. You know, we're not satisfied with coming up short, but this is our first go run with the guys that we have on this team. And one thing's for sure, Charles is not going to retire now. We won't let him.
And you won't either.
No, you're right.
Okay, KJ, we'll see you next season. Bob?
All right, from KJ to BJ, and you guys had a personal duel throughout this series.
Well, it was a challenge. If you want to be the best, you have to play against the best. And Kevin is a great guard. He's earned a lot of respect in this league, and I accepted the challenge, and I'm just glad that we prevailed as a team.
You got a chance to start this year, and even with Pax's return, you stayed in the lineup, and you've managed, on a team full of stars, a team that has Michael Jordan, to establish an identity of your own. Did you doubt that you'd be able to do that in the NBA?
No, I didn't. I never doubted that I could do it. I know it's going to be very tough. I know I had to come out and work hard and overcome a lot of challenges this year, but the guys stuck with me, and that was the most important thing, and I'm just glad it all worked out for the best.
BJ, congratulations.
Thank you, Bob.
We want to note that Charles Barkley has declined to speak with us. He is in the shower, and he is very disappointed, and we're going to have to leave the air now without hearing from Sir Charles. So the wrap-up here is pretty simple. The Bulls have three-peated. The nucleus of their club, still fairly young. They still have the desire. Next year, they'll try and come back, perhaps, and become the quad squad. For Marv Albert and Mike Fratello, Quinn Buckner,